Good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to the weekly special with me, the Digital Marketing Analyst. Today, we will be discussing affiliate marketing, looking particularly at a New York-based organization called The Wirecutter.
So what is affiliate marketing and who are Wirecutter? Essentially, the affiliate, in this case Wirecutter, uses a website blog to promote links to purchase items. And if the sale is made, they receive a commission. Wirecutter does this by spending hours testing these products and creating reviews for the ones they believe are the best. Affiliate marketing can generate big results when done properly and genuinely. I have chosen to analyze Wirecutter because of how they managed to utilize the development of the internet, and in particular, the rise of the Amazon marketplace. Only 4 years after Wirecutter's launch in 2011, and it was generating $150 million in e-commerce revenue, although its affiliate cut of that revenue is obviously much smaller. Due to the rise of technology, affiliate relationships now mostly work on a cost per action model, which is much safer to click fraud than the old cost per click ads. Cost per action means no one gets paid unless the required conversion takes place, for example, the sale or sign up, making it clear that the conversion is the result of an affiliate. This is tracked via a cookie that is placed on the user's web browser. With Wirecutter focusing on gear and gadgets, their target audience is between the ages of 25 to 45. Either new homeowners or those just looking to improve their homes or everyday life. Therefore, a website blog was the perfect way to reach this audience, and the choice of this was pinnacle for their success. As Seth Godin said in his book, This is Marketing, the most important thing to worry about is the substance of content. Work that matters for the people who care. And these were the two biggest things that Wirecutter focused on. To do this, they took a very buyer-oriented approach by always having the buyer's interests in mind. Jessica Spear, the site's director of revenue, confirmed in an interview that Wirecutter publishes product recommendations regardless of whether there's established affiliate relationships with the companies. For any given product, there could be dozens of potential e-retailers to link to. For this, Wirecutter has strict criteria they look at, including the reliability of return policies, the reputability of the supplier, and if their customer service is good. This way, they ensure that their audience can trust all the recommendations they give. One of the areas where Wirecutter stands out is through their customer experience design. As described in the European Management Journal 2007, in an increasingly competitive marketplace, the ability of an organization to create a positive customer experience delivers a superior competitive advantage. One way Wirecutter enhances their customer experience is through their contextual interaction. On their website, they enable individuals to share and like their content with others, either by email or on Facebook or Twitter. According to Forlizzi and Batterbee 2004, this action benefits Wirecutter by allowing the consumer experience to be influenced by observing and being observed by others. The final way they enhance their customer experience design is simply through their system quality, which can be broken down into three dimensions: system availability, system efficiency, and system security. These are all kept up to very high standards at Wirecutter, and is why their audience can rely on the website at any time. Wirecutter's biggest problem is that for most of their existence, consumers must stumble across their website when looking for what products to buy. To try and reduce the impact of this, Wirecutter is extremely active on Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter, posting their daily deals. Although the best way for them to utilize their affiliate marketing is to build and maintain an audience that consumes the site's content on a more regular basis. To do this, I would recommend Wirecutter introduces a subscription service. With this service, subscribers could receive exclusive discounts that aren't given for that product anywhere else. This could be achieved by leveraging their relationships with e-retailers to say, look, if you can offer us an exclusive coupon code, we will share that to our, say, 300,000 subscribers in our deals section, driving more traffic and people to you than you would have organically. This also benefits Wirecutter by giving people an incentive to buy through them, increasing their affiliate revenue. As much success as Wirecutter has had through its affiliate sales, it is important for them to explore other revenue models. One area they have started to explore, but I believe needs a lot more time and resources allocated to it, is the idea of licensing out their logo. This is an opportunity for brands to boast about being ranked on Wirecutter's imprimatur in their advertising. Because of the reputation Wirecutter has built up, they act as a mark of approval for e-retailers, which results in a form of earned media for the brands. For Maslin and Chevalier 2006, there's evidence suggesting that earned media can have a direct effect on sales. This is because it is perceived to be commercially unbiased, and in most cases is based on a direct experience. As Wirecutter's reviews are always based on a direct experience, they can also be described as electronic word of mouth, which is known to be one of the most effective forms of marketing communications. Therefore, Wirecutter is creating an advertising opportunity for thousands of businesses that are already ranked on their website. Since their launch in 2011, Wirecutter has set the standard for affiliate marketing. In 2016, they were bought outright by the New York Times for $30 million, which highlights the large audiences the site was reaching. If the Times can keep the high standards Wirecutter has set, the site will only continue to expand with the extra support and resources.
Thanks for listening, and please feel free to email me with any of your digital marketing questions.